Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. My name is Harold Campos and today I will be speaking about how to manage IBM DB2 mainframe modernization dependencies with the Microsoft DRDA service, part 1. Mainframe modernization has multiple phases and approaches. We can do lift and shift, we can do code conversion or refactoring, we can rewrite applications, or we can decide to coexist or extend our workloads. Now, there are other patterns available as well, like replatform, lift and shift with changes, mainframe as a service, mid-ranges as a service, or retire the mainframe and the workloads in it. But what are customers saying? We run a survey to understand potential blockers of adoption of cloud technologies. And what did they say? Help me with my on-premises dependencies. And that's exactly what we do and where we are investing, in helping those customers who remain on-premises and those who are moving to our cloud with cloud-native capabilities to integrate with mainframes that have been brought to the cloud, rewritten, code converted, or etc. Azure Logic Apps includes legacy integration capabilities in the cloud model that our customers choose, but HCOSS Integration Server also helps with this, and today we will talk about both. In a previous video called Patterns for a Gradual Modernization of Mainframes Using Azure Logic Apps and HCOSS Integration Server, I discussed the multiple approaches and patterns that we have available. You can find this video in the channel. And basically, we discussed at depth what was the strangler fig pattern and the anti-corruption layer, how a combination of both with Logic Apps and HCOSS Integration Server can provide a strong scheme of coexistence and also a gradual migration for customers who are moving from the mainframe or integrating with the cloud. HCOSS Integration Server on Azure Virtual Machines continues providing SNA gateway capabilities, and it also provides the DRDA application server, which is the service that we are going to be speaking about in the next few minutes. We have multiple alternatives and great replication solutions in-house and also from partners for data replication goals. And you can find some of these architectures available in the Azure Architecture Center that includes multiple mainframe and mid-ranges modernization topologies. Now, mainframes have multiple dependencies, internal and external, and we all know that, right? So if in this attempt to simplify the complex topologies that customers have, I have highlighted the mainframe on the right side and the potential clients on the left side. Right? You have all kinds of application and database servers. You have IBM I systems or iSeries systems. You have printers, desktop web applications, terminals, bank ATMs. So they all are connected to a mainframe either using SNA or TCP/IP or HTTP. Right. So then, if you were to imagine a world, or if you were to do a mainframe modernization, complete or gradual, to, for instance, Raincode environment on Azure, you will have a cloud-native environment that will be fulfilling all of the functions that your mainframe fulfilled in the past. But in the effort to provide coexistence, not only during the transition, but also with the workloads that are left on the client side. So then that's where our service for DRDA and the Logic Apps mainframe and mid-ranges connectors come to play. We will talk more about those. I just wanted to highlight the need and the use of them in this type of topology. Similar, if you have an OpenText or MicroFocus environment that is running now on Azure, if you were to deploy enterprise server, MicroFocus or OpenText now, they provide what is called the host compatibility options for SQL Server or HCOSS that basically allows this translation that will permit your COBOL programs to interact with a new created SQL Server database instead of going to DB2 because it's doing the translation for you. Now, from a client's perspective, you have our connectors as well, the Logic Apps connectors and the DRDA service and the SNA gateway available with HCOSS Integration Server to provide this coexistence with these legacy workloads that are still running outside the mainframe, or new workloads as well. So then, if we take IBM DB2 for today's video, let's see that you have today a Java or .NET application connecting to IBM DB2. and you migrate the data from IBM DB2 to Microsoft SQL Server. So you have to retarget your Java or .NET application to Microsoft SQL Server now. So instead of refactoring everything, that's where the DRDA AS service come to play. It will give you this translation layer available for you to retarget applications, existing applications and clients into SQL Server with almost no changes to your application. So then this will take us to a definition of what the Microsoft services for DRDA or the DRDA application server is. The Microsoft service for DRDA is an application server part of HIS that converts DRDA objects and formats into corresponding Microsoft connections, commands, data types, and error objects. This allows customers to deploy new Microsoft SQL Server workloads while still connecting to workloads based on IBM DB2. So then you have IBM DB2 today. In the future, you will have DRDA AS and SQL Server. Now, what can we do with the Microsoft DRDA service? We can enable IBM DB2 clients such as C#, Java, COBOL, or RPG to access Microsoft SQL Server. It also allows extending IBM DB2 operations to Microsoft SQL Server. If you're running ZOS or IBMI, you can extend your operations to SQL Server on Azure or on-premises. And finally, the Microsoft DRDA service provides tracing, session pooling, and high availability. I think if you are wondering how is this configured, you will need host integration server, and you will have to enable the Microsoft DRDA service. We'll show you how to do that. You'll connect then your workload based on IBM DB2 to the HIS server instead of IBM DB2, because HIS will be now the translator, and you will access the msdrdaservice.exe.config file. You will make some changes where you will adjust the port, connection string, right? And that's the work that you need to do to enable your client application to connect to the new data that is now residing in SQL Server. So now let me show you how this works in this short demo. So this always happens. So what I'm going to show you is the simple configuration in host integration server of the DRDA service, and also how a C# client uses the DRDA service, and then how a Java client uses it as well. Okay, so I have I have a virtual machine here that has Java and has also C#. So I have two clients, one C# client and one Java client, and they are originally connected to DB2. They both are querying the area table in a DB2 catalog. I will show it to you just in a minute. So let me go and log on to the other server. This one, of course, I have to log on again. So we have in this case, this host integration server that I have here has this configuration. You configure the common settings, network integration, data integration, and in data integration, you have the option to enable the service for DRDA, right? So then you check the service for DRDA, you add a service account, right? And then you are all set. The next thing that you need to do is you need to go to the configuration file, msdrda, service.exe.config in the system path of the Microsoft Host Integration Server install path in program files, and then you can adjust the port, and then you can adjust the connection string that you are using, right? In this case, I'm using a local server because I have SQL Server installed in the same server, but you can point it to anywhere you want, right? So what I did is I created this Northwind DB2 database in SQL Server, and I have it replicated in IBM DB2 running on ZOS. So then what you will see is that I will be interacting to one to the DB2 database, and then I will retarget this to the DRDA service listener, and it will just access the data now in SQL Server, which is the same data right now, right? So then let me go to the host to see. See if we can access the data in DB2. Okay, I think it's this one. No. File manager for DB2. Then we have basic. Base, my table, sorry, all execute. So now this is the area data in the in my catalog, in the D12A catalog, right? So and you see in my SQL Server I have the same data. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you. Let me go back to the other server that has. No, this one. Next one. That has the client in C sharp. This client is now pointing to the mainframe that has DB2, the area table. So then when I execute the query, I get all of the data because it's pointed to DB2. So this is using our client, our DB2 client, and it executes the query. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just change the connection string because that is the only change that I need to do in the client to target. Now, what it's going to target, it's going to target the host integration server with the port that I specified, 446 this time. The database is going to be the name of the catalog that I have in SQL Server as opposed to the catalog that I had in DB2. And then I'll start the application. And then it accesses and it queries the data. So as you have seen here in this example, I have run the application. I haven't made the only change that I have made to the client application is just to the connection string, right? So then now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do something similar from my Java client, right? In this case, the Java client will connect to. To DB2, yeah, it connected to it, right? It got the data, it connected to CIS1, to my mainframe that has this IP, this port. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the target to point to the port 446 in my host integration server, DRDA service, to the Nordwind DB2 catalog. And then, well, I'll save the change, and then I have access to the same data. So I think it's quite clear here that the change that we made here to establish the connection between the clients, the C sharp client and the Java client, was fairly transparent to the server. So then, because the DRDA listener is acting as a translator for these queries that are coming from these both clients. So what are the takeaways for this short video? If you are looking to migrate from IBM DB2 to Microsoft SQL Server with minimal, in most cases none, changes to your C sharp or Java applications, you should use the Microsoft DRDA service. If you have mainframe or mid-range application dependencies, you can use Host Integration Server or Azure Logic Apps for coexistence. And a reminder that this is the first of many videos on dependencies management. Next video will showcase COBOL and RPG programs, extending operations from IBM DB2 to Microsoft SQL Server. Again, thank you for your time. If you have not subscribed to the channel, please do so, and I will be posting more videos on this topic. Thank you.